Good morning students, welcome back to the English Channel Prime. Students, in the last class we learnt the lesson 6 of science, that is changes around us. In this chapter we understood that changes are happening all over us, all around us, and it has some reason for which it happens. It can be categorized into different types, and one single change can be categorized into more than one category, and the effect of heat on these changes. So in this class, let's start with the exercises. So open page number 91. Let's start with the multiple choice question A. Heat can change dash, is it state of an object, size of an object, solubility, or all of the above? Yes children, it is all of the above. For example, when you are burning a butter, when butter is coming in contact with the heat, you can see the butter will melt. That means it from physical state it will become liquid state, and the size will also change, the solubility also will change. So it is all of the above. Next, which one of the following is a desirable change? Burning of coal, flood, burning of house, landslide. Look children, flood, burning of house, landslide, all are harmful. So burning of coal gives us energy, so it is a desirable change. Option A. 3. Dash is an example of periodic change. Motion of pendulum clock, motion of a cricket ball during a match, motion of hand while writing, motion of car on a long road. All these changes takes different time, but motion of pendulum of a clock needs the exact timing. So it is the option A, motion of pendulum of clock. Next, fourth question, dash is not an example of chemical change. Cooking of food, melting of wax, ripening of mango, burning of paper. Yes children, in this melting of wax is not an example of chemical change, because it doesn't change to a different element or substance. Next, fifth, if there is a change in composition of a substance, we call it a dash. Yes, we call it as a chemical change. The substance will be completely different. Next, in a physical change, dash happens, shape and color of the substance may change, composition of the substance does not change, no new substance is formed, or all of the above? Yes, it is all of the above. Option D. Seventh question, gaps are left between the railway tracks to avoid any accidents due to, yes it is, expansion of the iron metal, that is option A. We have already discussed this with examples. Now let's do B, fill in the blanks. Periodic changes occur after regular dash, yes it is regular interval of time. Second question, breaking ice cube into two pieces is a dash change. No new substance is formed, so it is a physical change. Third question, no new substances are formed during a dash change. Just now we discussed, yes it is physical change. Fourth question, if a change can be carried out as A, heat, B, cool A, the change can said to be, yes it is, after heating if you cool it is called as a physical change. Fifth question, when seeds are soaked in water, their dash decreases. Yes, they become soft, so their hardness decreases. Sixth question, irreversible changes are dash in nature, it's permanent in nature. Seventh, dash expand more than liquids for the same increase in temperature. Yes, gases expand more than liquids. Here they are loosely packed. Eighth, plucking of leaves is a dash, but dash change. Yes, plucking of leaves is irreversible, but physical change. Done. Now next, C, alternative response type, state true or false. First question, every change has some cause. Yes, it is true. Second question, principle of thermometer is that on heating mercury lowers down in the tube. No, it is false. It changes. Third, gases contract on cooling. Yes, it is true. State yes or no. First question, can all the changes be reversed? No, it is not true. Do metals expand on increasing the temperature? Yes, true. State right or wrong. We keep the food in the refrigerator to avoid its spoilage. Yes, right. Second, telephone wires sag during summers due to contraction. No, it is wrong. D, analogy type. First, non-periodic change is a, the example is earthquake. Similarly, periodic change, what is an example of periodic change? Yes, it is formation of day and night, or you can write any change which is periodic like pendulum, clock. Next, natural change, rainfall. Similarly, man-made change, that is, you can give an example as cooking food. Next, E, very short answer type questions. First question, give any two examples where substance became harder on heating and two examples where substances became softer on heating. Yes, let's write down the answer. Yes, the bread becomes hard on heating and batter of cake or potato or any vegetable, they become soft when it is baked. Clear? Next, to walk through a waterlogged area, you usually ascertain the length of your dress by folding it. Can this change be reversed? Yes, children, it is reversible or not? Yes, it is reversible. Third question, a bag of cement lying in the open gets wet due to rain during the night. The next day, the sun shines brightly. Do you think the changes which have occurred in the cement could be reversed? Can it be reversed? No, it will become very hard. So it is no. Next, fourth, mention a change which is always desirable and one which is always undesirable. Yes, children, cooking a food is always desirable, but the same food when it gets spoiled or spoiling a food is always undesirable. Next, you can also write that rain is always desirable, but sometimes when we don't need it, it is undesirable. When it floods, it is undesirable. Fifth question, are all physical changes reversible? If not, give two examples. Yes, children, most of the physical changes are also not reversible. For example, if you tear a paper or breaking a plate or plucking of fruits, etc., are irreversible. Next, F, short answer type questions. Can the same change be desirable at one time and undesirable at another? Explain with the help of two examples. Just now we discussed. Let's write down the answer. Yes, the same change can be desirable at one time and undesirable at another. For example, we want the fire to light up while cooking food. Then it is a desirable change. But if the same fire burns our belongings, burns our home, then it becomes an undesirable change. Second, the running of air condition is desirable in summers, but in winter it becomes undesirable. Second question, differentiate between physical and chemical changes. Answer, those changes in which no new substance is formed are called the physical changes. During physical changes, properties remain the same and these are mostly reversible. Under chemical changes, write down, new substances are formed during these changes. Second, the properties of substance changes. Third, these are mostly irreversible. Done. Third question, why do we need to study change? Explain giving examples. Answer, we need to study change to understand the development process. We must know about the outcome of any change. By studying about the change, we can understand the next stages of change. For example, recently in America, a tornado like tsunami came, but the scientists had already informed the government, hence there was no loss of life. Then, fourth question, what are the periodic and non-periodic changes? Give examples of both types. Answer, periodic changes. Make two columns under periodic changes. Write down, those changes which repeat themselves after regular intervals of time are called periodic changes. Second point, formation of day and night, movement of pendulum, etc. are the examples of periodic motion. Under the non-periodic changes, first point, write down, changes which do not repeat themselves regularly are called non-periodic changes. For example, floods and earthquakes, etc. are non-periodic in nature. Done. Fifth question, mention the various effects which a change can produce. Answer, the various effects which a change can produce are, first, there may be change in color. Second, there may be change in size. Third, change in shape. Fourth, change in position. 5th change in physical state, 6th change in hardness. 6th, how can a smaller iron rim be fitted on a larger wooden wheel? Answer, a smaller iron rim can be fitted on a larger wooden wheel by heating it. On heating, iron expands and can be fixed easily. Later it will can be cooled and kept tight. Next, 7th question, list the different effects produced on objects on heating and cooling. Answer, on heating and cooling the objects, the different effects produced are as follows. First, change in size. On heating, substances increase in size, and on cooling, the size of the material decreases. For example, iron, milk, mercury, etc. expand on heating and contract on cooling. Second, change in hardness of objects. On heating, some solid objects become soft, and on cooling, it becomes hard. Third, change in physical state of substances. For example, on heating and cooling, physical state of substances may also change. For example, ice, solid, if it will heat, it becomes water, that is liquid. If again you will cool it, water or water vapor, it will become when you heat it. G. Long answer type questions. What are the various categories in which we can classify changes? Explain giving an example of each. We can classify the changes in various categories like, first, natural and man-made change. The change brought about by nature are natural changes. For example, change of season. Changes which are brought about by man are called the man-made changes. For example, cooking of food. Second, slow and fast changes. Some changes which take hours, days, months or years to take place are called slow changes. For example, change of milk into curd. Some changes takes place in few seconds. They are fast changes. For example, blinking of eyes. Third, periodic and non-periodic changes. Those changes which repeat themselves after regular intervals of time are called periodic changes. For example, formation of day and night. Second, changes which do not repeat themselves after regular intervals of time are called non-periodic, for example, natural disasters. Fourth point, you can write desirable and undesirable changes. Some changes are useful to us and we want them to take place are desirable changes, for example, ripening of fruit. Some changes are harmful to us and we do not want them to happen. Those are called the undesirable changes. For example, spoiling of food. Next, reversible and irreversible changes. Those changes which can be reversed are reversible changes. For example, filling air to balloon and taking it out. Some changes cannot be reversed. For example, they are irreversible changes like burning of paper to ash or breaking a plate, etc. Done. Second question. Explain with the help of an activity that heat can change the physical state of an object. Yes, let's do. Write down answer. Activity to show that heat can change the physical state of an object. Take a metal ball and a metal wire. Make a loop of the wire in such a way that it is just as big as the ball. Now, the ball should be able to just fix inside the ring. Take out the ball and keep it aside. Now, hold the ring carefully with a pair of tongs and heat it. Pass the ball through the ring now. You'll find that now the ball easily passes through. This shows that ring expands on heating and contracts on cooling. Check out this diagram. Draw this diagram. Third question. Give reasons melting of ice cream is considered a physical change. Yes, melting of an ice cream changes the state from solid to liquid. Hence, it is a physical change. Folding a hanky is a reversible change. Folding of a handkerchief can be reversed by opening the handkerchief. So, it is a reversible change. Third, C. Ripening of fruits is considered as a chemical change. Yes, it is considered as a chemical change because a ripened fruit has different properties as compared to a raw or unripe fruit. Hence, it is a chemical change and it cannot be reversed. Next, H, checklist type. Complete the following table by putting a tick for each category under which a given change falls. So look at this checklist. First change, melting of ice. Yes, it comes under natural change. It comes under slow change, reversible change and physical change. Next, falling of leaves comes under natural, slow, irreversible and physical change. Third, bursting of crackers comes under man-made change, first change, irreversible change, chemical change and non-periodic change and a desirable change. Fourth, preparation of food by plant. Yes, it comes under natural change, slow change, irreversible change, chemical change and desirable change. Fifth, cooking of food comes under man-made change, slow change, irreversible change, chemical change and also desirable change. Done, children? I hope we completed all this lesson. Thank you, children.